it actually holds.
YouTube, what is going down, man? I'm back at y'all boys again with another video, bro. And look, it's time to talk about shooting, man, because this is one of the most controversial things in the community, right? I mean, every time I'm getting on Twitter, what am I seeing? I'm seeing so many people. It's either two sides, you know what I'm saying? Either on one side or the other. One side saying shooting is perfect. It's fine. Matter of fact, shooting may be even too easy. If you can't shoot, if you ain't making your shots, you're trash. You might not have your badges. Do you know how many times in the past 2 weeks I've heard people say, well, man, you ain't got your badges. You know what I'm saying? Once you get your badges, you're going to see how easy this shooting lifestyle is on NBA 2K20. It's fine. Y'all complaining just to complain. Oh, you can't make your shots. You're trash. That's one side, right? And obviously, the opposite side of that, the other side of that is going to be the complete opposite of what I've just said. Those are people that are saying, look, I got my badges. I have the rating. I got a 90-something mid-range. I got an 80-something three-pointer. I got a 90-something mid-range. I got a 90-something three-pointer. And I'm still breaking full whites. I have my badges. Please stop saying I don't have my badges. This is all I see on my timeline. It's all I see. So I want to make a video on, let's talk about it as a family, man. All of my subscribers, what do we think? What are we thinking about shooting, man? Now, NBA 2K20 shooting for me, at times it seemed easy. It really does. And look, use the footage in the background as proof that it tells you Trey know how to time a jumper. You know what I'm saying? It's really not too hard if we being completely honest. Especially if you can find a good jumper like the one I got in this video. I honestly don't know if I'm going to let this thing out, bro. Because, look, they spilled the beans about jump shot 38. And that 38 is trash. I can't even use it. But the one I got right now, straight green. You know what I'm saying? Even when I lean, it's green. Like I said, use that footage in the background as proof to show you that I know how to time a jumper. And for me, at times of shooting, does feel too easy. Or matter of fact, not even too easy. I won't say too easy. The shooting feels perfect. I ain't gonna lie. Man, when you greening, when you in the zone with your player, when you got your badges going, you got that green machine on. Look, the shooting cannot get any more perfect until, for me, I get a full bar. Now, look, I'm one of those people. Let me go ahead and reveal which side of the gang I'm on. Hey, man, pass them full bars, man. Pass the full bars. Now, Mike Wang has came out. He let us know that full bars are going to be addressed. And when I say pass the full bars, I don't mean make all of the shooting easier. I don't mean that. I mean leave everything the way that it is. Just knock up the percentage slightly about how many full bars you make, because there are entirely way too many misses. And I'm showing y'all footage, so can't nobody say, oh, bro, you trash showing how to time a jumper. Look at the footage. What I got to lie for? But let me show y'all some footage of the full bars and why I think that it needs to be addressed. Bro, look, I got an 88 mid-range. And I'm sorry, I got an 88 three-pointer, an 87 mid-range. Now, yes, the moving shots have been patched, but that's not an excuse for the full bars that we are missing. Look at how many full bar movements and standings I'm missing with an 87 mid-range and an 88 three. Y'all seen the clip at the beginning of the game? That's annoying. I think annoying player. I think he used the Pytro where it was all shooting. That's 90-something mid, 90-something three. And he missing full bars. But people going to sit here and tell me that the game and the shooting is perfect. That there's no problem with the full bars. We just got to time it better. Like, what you wanted me to do? We have the ratings. Please stop telling me, wait till I get my badges. I got my goddamn badges. I'm so tired of seeing people say, yo, wait till you get your badges, wait till you get your badges. What about when I got them and them shots are still breaking? What you gonna say, find a better release? Man, I done tried a few of them. When they green is good, But all of them still, when they full bar, most of the times it's nothing but clanks, man. The full bars are absolutely ridiculous, and that's why I think that Mike Wang is going to address it. All of y'all dudes are saying, look, if I'm doing it, why can't you? Bro, we're timing it. You know what I'm saying? I don't know about everybody else. I really don't. But I know how to time a jumper, bro. I'm not slow. It's not that hard, bro. Honestly, timing the jumper, really, I don't even consider that skill filling up a bar, bro. It's really easy if you got some good anticipation how to fill up a bar. Now, creating space, getting open, that requires some skill. I think I do a pretty decent job at that. I wouldn't call myself comp or nothing, but I ain't completely trash at the game. And I'm still here telling you, full bars need to be addressed, bro. Full bars is absolutely trash. Most of the time, it's full bar opens. Full bar wide opens. Now, if I'm shooting a full bar and it's contested, then punish me. You know what I'm saying? Don't let me make that shot. But why the hell am I missing full bars when I got all of the badges? I got the rating. Matter of fact, look, I'm even using floor general, so it lets me know when I was open. So I know before I even shoot the shot I was open, right? Why am I missing all of these full bars? So for all of the dudes that are saying shooting is perfect, I agree with you. It's almost perfect, bro. Like, I promise you, the 2K20 shooting, especially when you in a zone, is amazing, bro. Man, my greens ain't never snapped faster in any 2K, bro. The jumper that I have right now in this video, I'm in love with the jumper, bro. I hope the 2K never patches this jumper, bro, because once you find out how to time it, it's a real good jumper, right? But I still do agree that full whites need a tiny buff, because you can't green every shot. I don't care how much you do think that you got so much skill, you can't green everything. Some games you're gonna green everything. Like, I got footage of me greening almost every shot. Matter of fact, I think I greened every shot in the game. I think I'm putting it on the screen right now. But I've had games where I greened all my shots, all of them. But the ones that I missed, guess what I missed? They full bar. You know what I'm saying? And I don't want to make every full bar. I don't want to do that. And I also don't want the shooting to be like NBA 2K19, where we're going to have center shooting from the top of the arc, center shooting from the corner, non-shooting bills equipped in a jumper, and they all of a sudden become just as good as shooters as sharps. I don't want it to go that way. I don't want the sharpshooter takeover to become like the sharpshooter takeover from 19. All I'm simply saying is buff the full whites a little bit. How can you play this game and see everybody clanking these full whites, seeing a lot of guards missing all of these full whites, and then you just sit here and say shooting is completely perfect? It's nearly perfect. It's nearly good enough, but it's not good enough, bro. I can't think of another 2K that has had this many full bar misses. It's not hard to time a jumper, but it's ridiculous. If I create space, I'm doing everything that I need to do, and clank. It's a reason why centers are not helping dudes off screens anymore. They're leaving guards out to die. You want to know why? Because if you can't green that shot, it's off. It's off. I'm not telling Mike Wang to touch everything with shooting. I hope that he don't. I really hope that he don't. But full bars, garbage. Plenty of times, you in the rhythm. You are in a hot zone. Got hot zone hunt on Hall of Fame. Big clanks in the chat. And if you one of them dudes that's worried about if they buff full bars that non-shooting bills are going to be able to shoot, well, man, look, please, I hope you're sitting down, because I got news for you. They can shoot in the game right now. This footage is from today. This dude is a center. He's not a shooting archetype. Now, I don't know what pie chart he used, but he's 7 feet. Now, I ain't seen no pie chart that gave 7 foot dudes a burner from behind the damn 3-point line, but this dude, he's a non-shooting build, and he's timing his jumper, hitting them consistently, greening. So if you got a problem with non-shooting builds hitting shots and you don't want them to be able to do that, why don't I see you on Twitter complaining about non-shooting builds hitting shots? I don't really see nobody complaining about that. But dudes that's supposed to be able to hit them shots, that have the ratings, that got their badges, that's missing them, once we complain, we trash at the game. You know what I'm saying? But I just honestly, again, want to know y'all boys' opinion. I know at the end of the day, I can't sway nobody else's opinion, and I really don't even care to. But what y'all definitely need to do is stop the lying, man. Stop pretending like you don't see the problem with the full bars in the game. But that's just my 2 cents on this whole topic, man. I know this is going to be a heavy debate throughout the year, man. But again, that's all I got for y'all boys. Man, make sure that you like, subscribe, hit those notifications so you can join the gang. And, we out.